Hey guys, what's going on? Lucky here. I am at the shop. I got a couple days to play catch up at my shop on some projects. And walking around looking for Sticks. Sticks McGann. Ooh, Sticks McGann. Got a broken leg. But right now I'm in the middle of three projects at the same time. I got my guy Mason over here doing body work on the surf truck that belongs to a friend of mine named Yo. And it's been here for a long time. It was in the other shop. It was a complete, it showed up disassembled, literally every bolt removed, and we've done a ton of work to it. And after the last weather change, saw some cracks in the primer, and there being some issue with the paint that they used on the bed, or the primer sealer they used on the bed. So we stripped it back down and just got done redoing it, or was in the middle of redoing it. This is for the Andrew 62 up there. All the oak showed up finally, and the frame or the bed sides are out being sandblasted right now. Obviously my wagon's back, next project up there. But right now I had my buddy Tony call me up, and he is building a 59 or a 60, Brookhurst or something like that. It's a Ford, Chevy wagon, 59 or 60 Chevy wagon. It's pretty cool. And these are the headlight buckets, the little fender extensions that stick out the side of the fenders and hold the headlights. And it's pretty common. I can tell you which one's left, which one's right. This is the right front. I'm sorry, left front, because the bottom rusts out. And this is the left front, or right front, because the bottom rusts out. So they bolt to the side of the grille and fender like that. What I've done is cut out the rusted part, made some patterns, have some metal here. I hit it with some Dycom, and I'm going to transfer the pattern over right now. If this stuff is dried, pretty close. You just give it a little accelerate. And all right, so what I did was, which one has the biggest piece, Missy? Yeah, this is a pretty good size piece. Am I holding this thing in a position where you can see? I believe I am. Anyway, cut out the damaged part right there. Completely. They've been sandblasted, obviously. Cut out that part. Was more concerned of leaving good metal on, cutting off all the old stuff. I went all the way to the end where the still good metal on either side. Use that as a pattern just to get a rough. After I got a rough, I then taped this piece to the actual component, and then used a sharp tip pen or Sharpie to actually get in there and get every little nook and cranny. As you can see, like right here, there was a step. I could have sanded that out, but it's easier just to make a pattern. The more metal on there, the better. So now I have a pretty accurate pattern that, if I transfer it correctly, it should work out well. So, I'm gonna transfer this pattern right here, right there. And I would normally get a sharp scribe, which just happen to have right here. Perfect. And because I put the Dycom down, I can do stuff and it will show up. So the only thing you really have to be careful about when you do this is you should mark which side is up and which side is down, especially if it has a couple curves in it. I've gotten them all together, almost completely done, and then realized I curved it the wrong way. Thank you. Yeah, I feel pretty good about that. Once again, I'm going to be using the grinder to actually carve this in. It's pretty close. Then I have one more piece right here. Move this a little bit further over because I want to use the beverage shear. Scribe is it's hard to describe. See what I did there? I think maybe I was using it to chisel something, or there's a couple different sharp points. Okay. That's pretty close, and it is. All right, now I could use the cutoff wheel and incision it and then grind it all down, but I actually have a beverage shear over here. I'll go over there and I'll get it kind of close. These things, as long as you keep them tuned, they work great, but as soon as they get a little bit messed up, they are not so cool anymore. I will get as close as I can because I will use the grinder to get that exact fit. Also, one of the things with the beverage shear is the part that goes underneath is going to get a little distorted. So you want to keep your project on the flat. Thank you.
Here's one of the cool parts of about a Beverly Shears. You can do a pretty decent little turn on it. Now I can use the sander and just go cut in there, cut in there. Shape this thing. Very happy with that. And also this Beverly Shear is a total knockoff. Works fine. Still hunting for an OG one, but for now that'll do. If you guys recall, I cut these lines really close, so I should be able to make the lines disappear. Remember making that line seeing two, that was a messed up tip. Dip it in the water. Funny how when you're grinding on metal, it tends to get warm. I'm gonna look at it really close. See which lines I can see when I can't see. I have one line right there. There's a double line. So it's questionable as to exactly how that fit in there. So I'm using the edge of the bench to put the curve in it. What's up, Jason?
Sorry, man.
That's all right. What you doing?
I'm gonna steal a piece of scrap metal from you.
Help yourself.
You know, piece of aluminum. What are you up to?
I am patching up some 59 station wagon components here, headlight buckets.
Nice. Wait, 59?
59 or 60.
Who's that?
It's Tony from HRP.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, we're back at it. I'm going to use a Scotch-Brite, buzz the edges of these fittings, or these panels.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna touch up a couple more spots. Then I'll hit this whole thing with some rust mort. Seal it up really well. Knock it around a little bit with the hammer, and that'll be like the finished product right there. Because this is inside of a fender, underneath some chrome pieces. Like metal finishing it. Just gonna get it close where it doesn't rust anymore. And then rust mort it up. Doesn't look bad at all. Okay guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a comment, share the video if you like it, and thanks a lot. See you later.